Az-Zahra salaamullahi faced that propaganda. She stood against it. But she also, unfortunately, was not immune from the aggression. Even though she's the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. She's the beloved heart of Rasulullah, the soul of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. The only mother of his grandchildren. Her house is the house of Wahi, where Jibra'il used to take permission to attend, to enter. Jibra'il, as we read in Hadith al-Kisa, asked for permission to go into the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He said, Ya Allah, do you give me permission? Ya Rasulullah, do you give me permission? He asked for permission. Jibra'il asked for permission. This is the house. But those people, no permission was asked. But rather, they came to attack. One of the sheikhs, a very well-respected sheikh by the name of Sheikh Abdul-Zahra al-Kaabi, may Allah bless his soul, he used to read in the shrine of Imam al-Hussein, salamullah alayhi. He says, one night in my dream, I saw Imam al-Hassan and Imam al-Hussein, alayhim as-salam. They told me, ya sheikh, why don't you read our musibah, our calamity, our tragedy? He said, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, I always read your musibah in the shrine of Imam al-Hussein. I remember you every day almost. He said, they looked at me and they said, Ya Sheikh, that's not our musibah. That's not the biggest tragedy that we faced. He said, then tell me what is it and I will read it. They said, Ya Sheikh, on the day they attacked our mother Fatima, and we saw her collapsing to the ground, bleeding, killing our brother Al-Muhsin. Then they tied the ropes around the hands of our father Amir Al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, and they took him outside the house. Ya Sheikh, at that moment, my brother and I looked at each other. We didn't know what to do. Shall we stay with our mother who's bleeding on the floor? Or shall we run after our father who's being taken to the masjid? We started crying, Aywa Jadda wa Rasulallah. Oh, my grandfather, Ya Rasulallah, come and help us, tell us what to do. Then Zainab alayha salam was there seeing her mother Fatima salamullahi alayha. Fatima then looked at Zainab. She said, Zainab, where is your father? She said, mother, they took him to the masjid. They took him outside. Fatima salamullahi alayha got up. She forgot about her wounds and her pain and her blood. She put on her hijab and came out crying, خلوا ابن عمي أو لأكشف للدعاء رأسي. Leave my cousin or I will pray against you. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam turned to Salman and said, Ya Salman, go back to Fatima and make sure she doesn't raise her hands in the dua. For wallah, if she does, all those people will be eliminated. Salman came back to her. He said, O daughter of Rasulullah, bu'itha abaki rahmatan lil alameen, fala takuni ala ha'ula'i al-qawm naqima. Your father was sent as a mercy to the universe. Don't be a curse against those people. She said, my uncle, ya Salman, ya am. They took my haq, they took my right, and I was patient. They attacked my house, and I'm patient. They killed my baby, and I'm patient. But now they want to orphan my children, Hassan and Hussein. Wallah, I will not let them do this. خلوا ابن عمي أو لأكشف للدعاء رأسي. قالت وأظفار المصاب بقلبها غوثاه عز على العداة معيني. بويا خلاف عينك ما رعوني قومك يا بويا لوعوني ومن البجع لك منعوني ورا الباب لما نهيسون يكسروا ضلعي ابويا وسقطوني. Then the man ordered his servant, he said, go back to Fatima. He came back to Fatima and he hit her with his whip. She fell down to the ground crying, Aywa Abata, Aywa Rasulallah. قل للمغيب تحت أطباق الثرى إن كنت تسمع صرختي وندائي صبت على أي مصائب لو أن صبت على الأيام صرنا ليالي إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين.